We can also shift parabolas or move them around on the coordinate plane. Let's take a look at our original equation, y equals x squared. If we add 1 to the equation, we can see that the entire graph shifts up 1 unit. Notice before that the vertex was at 0, 0. And now our vertex is at 0, 1. By adding 1 right here to the end of our equation, we really increase all the y values from before by 1. This is why the entire graph, the orange graph, shifts 1 unit up. So a point that was at negative 1, 1 is now at negative 1, 2. And a point that, say, was at 2, 4 is now at 2, 5. Notice how the y value increased by 1. We could also make this graph go up 2 units, 3 units, 4 units, or even 8 units. So we can see that adding a constant term to the end of our parabola will shift it up. So if we subtract a number, it will shift it down. The parabola y equals x squared minus 3 is our original parabola, only it's been shifted down 3 units. And again, notice that the orange parabola had a vertex of 0, 0. And this new parabola has a vertex of 0, negative 3. We could even change this to be a negative 5, so that way the orange parabola would shift down 5 units. And again, notice that the vertex of this last parabola is 0, negative 5. We can see that the y-coordinate of the vertex comes from here. This negative 5 is right here on our vertex. The x-coordinate of our vertex is 0. And it turns out it comes from solving this binomial, or setting this binomial equal to 0. X minus 0 is still x, so we know that this term is really still x squared. And if I graph this equation, I can see that they're exactly the same. I'm just writing this in a different form. So now we can quickly see where this vertex comes from in our equation. The 0 is here, and the negative 5 is here. Now, we've seen shifting a parabola up and down. Well, we can also see a parabola shifted left and right. So we know by adding 3 on the end, we could shift the parabola up 3 units. To shift the graph left or right, we're going to change this binomial. If I subtract 1 from x, it really moves the graph 1 unit to the right. Now the vertex is here. Notice that the sine of the x-coordinate of the vertex is opposite from the one in here. For a y equals parabola, we can set this binomial equal to 0 to find the x-coordinate of the vertex. So in this case, x would equal 1. The y-coordinate of the vertex is simply found by the number that's added or subtracted at the end of the equation.